and welcome to Saurav Sir's classes. Today's tutorial will be on law. In case of any query, you can contact us on this number. And if you wish to know more about us, you can check in our website. Now let us look at the principle. The principle says whoever does not arrest, you know, the killer, the one who is committing the crime, and report the matter to the concerned authority. So you are hiding information from the concerned authority, not relating the information you have, nor you have attempted to arrest the killer, the criminal, okay? Then it means you have committed an offense. This is not correct. So you have committed offense in the eyes of law. Now let us look at to the fact. Now there are three women, okay? And first is referred as A, second as B, and third is as C. So let us see. A sees B killing C. So A looks that B kills C. Okay. So A is the witness. Okay. Now A neither attempts to arrest B, which is the criminal in our case, nor inform the concerned authority, police or any one legal authority. So this principle, so this kind, some a situation has taken place and A has neither tried to arrest or capture the killer B, nor the woman does not inform the police, concerned authority. Now let us see which option will be correct. Now B has committed an offense. Now here B has definitely killed C, so B has definitely committed an offense. But here we are talking about the person who observed, who is present at the crime, there where the crime is taking place, where he looks at the killer and those and the person who is the victim. So he is the observer or he is present at that moment. Okay. So B has definitely committed the offense, but here we need to look at A, what A has done. Okay. So B is not the correct option. B has not committed an offense. We are not concerned about B. We are only here concerned about A. Okay. Now the next is A has committed an offense. Now A has definitely committed an offense because A has neither attempted to arrest B, nor he informed the concerned authority. So he has not followed the principle. So he has definitely committed an offense. The last option is A has not committed an offense. Why not? The woman has committed an offense by not informing the police or by not arresting B. So C will be the correct option. The next principle says that there is a person named A who is usually unsound mind but occasionally normal. So sometime he is not, his mind is not functioning well, but sometime he is normal. That means his senses, his brain is functionally the way it is supposed to. Okay. Now he may take a contract. So such kind of person can also take the contract when he is not unsound mind. That means he is, when he is normal, absolutely fit. Okay. So such kind of person can take. So this is the principle. Now let us look at the fact. So A is generally mean in the state of unsound mind and rarely becomes capable of understanding the things. But he becomes capable. Rarely means sometime at least he is capable of understanding things. That means he can, based on this principle, we can say because sometimes he can, he becomes capable of understanding things, he can, he may take a contract when he is not at all of unsound mind. So let us look at the options. So A can never make a contract. This is absolutely wrong. He can. A can make contract at any time when he pleases. No, because at all the time he is not normal or fit. Most of the time he is unsound mind. It is said here. A can make a contract when normal. Now this is absolutely correct. And given the principle, he can make a contract when he is normal. His brain is functioning the same way of a normal person does. Okay. And A can make a contract only for his own benefit. This is absolutely wrong. So given the principle, we know C will be the correct option. So I hope this short tutorial on law was helpful. If it was, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.